We've been joined in studio by Dr. Eric Asamoah Dako. He's the Deputy Secretary General of the Ghana Red Cross Society. And I would want to just pose a few questions to him. Good evening, sir. Thank you for joining us. We have barely heard anything from the Red Cross Society. What are your initial comments on the entire ambulance debate?
Thank you very much, my brother. You've not heard from us because the case is fresh, and Red Cross want to take our time to analyze the situation. I think all said and done, we would have loved that the ambulances are released on time for it to be given to the needed facilities and the constituencies as President wish to be. It's unfortunate that a date proposed and it couldn't materialize. Mm. I think that it's something that, to us at Ghana Red Cross, we're not happy. What we have to conceive is just the fact that, for the first time, technical advisors are advising the politicians as to what it is and what we should do. Indeed, if they think that one or two things are not ready, which I don't want to go into why they are not ready for now, and for that matter, we should postpone and get it right. I think that it's good the president is adhering to and giving us a few days to get it fixed. After all, on the 6th and 13th to 20th, even though it's time, but it's not too much that we can't wait. So I think that it's better we exercise a bit patience and get it done.
But what are your assessments of Ghana's entire health sector? Clearly, many have mentioned the challenges we've been facing. But then from the perspective of the Ghana Red Cross Society, how do you assess Ghana's health sector?
Well, as a developing country, we are not doing bad at all.
Are we?
Just that, yes, we
really?
Are not doing bad at all. just that our ambulance system is not the best as we wanted. You see, the former presidency did a lot in hospital facilities and all sort of things. What is needed now is for us to push and get things also fixed for it to run properly. The ambulance service, as we're well aware at Ghanaian, is not doing well at all in Ghana. And for that matter, when we heard of this, it was a good news to us. We are praying that things get better. But I think, like I said, it's a developing world. We're not doing just bad at all. Mm. We need to, yes, we still need more. I can assure you. We still need more in terms of doctors not being posted, nurses not having this.
Congestions at our various hospitals.
All these are concerned to us. But the ambulance system needs to be upgraded.
And from what you said, what also can you tell us about the role these ambulances would play in delivering, making your job easier, the job of the Ghana Red Cross Society?
Yes, Red Cross, what we do is when there's emergency, we try to stabilize the condition. We don't have the facility to evacuate. And evacuation is where ambulance service comes in. Mm. So indeed, a good collaboration with the National Ambulance Service helped to evacuate some of these things to the nearest facilities, hospitals, as fast as possible. Indeed, it's really good to help. You realize that to curb the accidents, fatalities on the road, Ghana Red Cross and National Road Safety has built health posts in most of the accident-prone areas.
Right.
Yet there's no one ambulance in any of the facilities. And as a result, it's not working well. We would have loved that ambulances are ready, get all these things in just positions and carry people to
the how have you been managing through the years when we, for a country of about 25 million population, you have just about 50 operating ambulances? How have you coped? How have you worked and managed your affairs?
I wish this question is posed to ambulances because we don't directly control the ambulances.
Work with them. Yeah, yeah, but at least you stabilize whatever
the
emergency there is.
And then, you know, Ghana, we are fond of using other vehicles, taxis and whatever, which is not the best at all. But situation where ambulance is not there, you have distant using the alternative, which is, to me, is not the best. Mm. So we all love that this ambulance that has come will be in operation to support the health sector as we want it to be.
Okay, we are concluding the conversation now, but then the point we majority are asking is, if all these things that have been mentioned by the ambulance service, including the proper training of the staff, the equipping of the ambulances, fitting them with tracking devices, etc., all these things that have been outlined, do you, from what you said, do you believe they'll be able to fix all of that in the time they are buying for themselves until the 28th of January, they say?
In fact, if I put Red Cross jacket down and I'm talking as individual, I don't want to buy into the excuses that they are giving.
Mm.
Because when Ghana, where ambulances came some time ago, and we're told that certain things were not fit, so either it was returned or we are not using, nobody knows.
Mm.
And then all of a sudden, another one has come, and we are still giving the same excuses.
Mm.
No, we can't be serious. So for me, I just want to reserve my comment on that, but I don't believe that is the reason why it's not on use.
Anyway, clearly, this is a conversation that will be going on in the next few days, hoping that by that 28th, which is the new proposed date for the distribution of the ambulances, we are hoping that we'll be able to get it as it is to all the constituencies around the country. Thank you very much, Dr. Eric Asamoah-Dakum, Deputy General Secretary, Deputy Secretary General of the Ghana Red Cross.